Miss Fry, I brought some books. I hope I'm not intruding by being here.
Quite the contrary. It's nice to have the company. A herbarium? Are you collecting flowers for someone?
Only myself. I'm told it's something of a British pastime. Did you know, they all have symbolic meanings?
I had heard something of the sort.
Of course you have. Unfortunately, I have no time to fill the book.
I could collect some samples, if you would accept my help.
I would appreciate that. Thank you, Miss Fry.
I was just thinking about Father.
Nice day for a bit of bloodshed, isn't it?
Yes, Cap. Oh.
To girl.
Yeah! Yeah!
No recollection of the events that landed you in a cell?
I remember what the other victims remember. A silver watch, the sound of a bell, and a sort of shadow.
A glint of silver and a tolling bell. I must say, you look very tired.
Yeah. I am so very, very tired.
Now you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
Now I'm going to do a little job of work for you.
You've cost me a bit of money, mate. So I think it's only fair that you replenish my coffers with donations from the good people of London. You will steal money for me, won't you?
Yes, I will steal money for you.
Good. Very good. Now, we can't have criminals like you roaming the streets. You will surrender to the police, won't you?
Yes. I will surrender to the police.
Oh, and when you do, you're going to do a silly little dance for them.
I say, you gave me a terrible fright, muttering about a man named Ezio.
Ezio Capelli. Not a demon, but a hypnotist. And he's not even Italian.
Anything made of
in the house. Release me at once. I admit it. I'm not Italian. It was just for my act. Nobody wanted to see a British hypnotist.
Oh, shut up.
I'll give you anything you want.
I want you to shut your mouth. Do you know a Dr. John Elliott?
Never heard of the man.
Did you really think mesmerism would work?
How dare you? I'm a hypnotist.
Thank you.
arrangement. You will not chase me anymore.
Time to confess and free the people under your silly spell.
Young friend, I'm sorry to be so blunt, but I need to ask a favor of you. A delivery awaits me at the docks, a very rare orchid, all the way from the island of Madagascar. But there is a problem. One of my associates wants the flower for himself. He sent ruffians to collect.
Thank you, my young friend. Thank you. Thank you, my young friend. Thank you. This little orchid may seem inconsequential, but it holds secrets which could potentially change our very understanding of the world. It would have been a shame to lose it. Shame indeed. Thank you.
Dear Darwin, do you think our young friend here, equipped with a pot of...
Mr. John Hammond?
That is correct.
Jacob Fry, Mr. Dickens sent me to meet you.
Now, good old Dickens. London. Can't say I've missed the weather. My father passed away recently, and I have come home to settle his affairs. Also, I am to be married.
You don't sound too keen on the idea.
I have never even met my future bride, Bella Wilton. It was all arranged for me. She may be a good woman, or she may not. Certain that the lady is not simply in it for the money? I can test my bride's sincerity. I am now officially dead and have thus shed my fortune. I shall meet Bella Wilton as a nobody. We shall see if she'll have me now. Come, we must dispose of my body. Find us a carriage to take us to the river. Good work. How exciting. This is like something out of a novel. Officially dead and have thus shed my fortune. I shall meet Bella Wilton as a nobody. We shall see if she'll have me now. Come, we must dispose of my body. Find us a carriage to take us to the river.